Christie here. I'm just adding this at the beginning because I always forget to do this when I'm in the video. Please, can you subscribe? Please share this video or press the little bell so that you don't miss my future videos. But if you subscribe, it goes into your feed. It doesn't spam you or anything. So remember to do that. Check out my website, like it says in the show notes, for any details about my coaching. And if you want to write your own book as well, we can get you started, I promise. All right, so let's jump onto the book review. Hi, Christie here. It's been a while since I've been on here, but this book has been so good, I've had to jump on and do a review. The Papers of Tony Veitch by William McIlvanney. Absolutely brilliant book. It was an award-winning book at the time it was written. It's not a new book at all. I've come really late to this author. His son's now an author. He's deceased. And this book actually is the sequel to a book called Laidlaw, which actually created its own genre, which is stunning and it's well deserved. And it sort of founded Scottish noir fiction. It's very dark, very gritty. This is, like I say, the sequel. I'm not sure you'd see this cover because it's a shocking picture, this as well, off Goodreads, but there's lots of different images. I think because it is such an old book, it's got many, many versions, so don't just look for this one cover. I'm actually considering buying this trilogy. I've got them as ebook, an audio book, and the audio is fantastic. I really, really highly recommend it, but I think I'm going to buy all these just to have on my bookshelf as well, because they are real classics. The genius writing. It's really gritty, really dramatic, a really grimy city portrayal detective novel, but makes you laugh because some of the words in it and some of the descriptions are excellent. I think one of them, I meant to take quotes, but it's so difficult when you've got audiobooks to sort of highlight the quotes. And that's why I'd like the books on my bookshelf, to be able to browse through them and flick through and see his descriptions, because his characterisations are almost Dickensian. They sort of, so they put this image in your head. There was one where he said his nose was sharp enough to cut, or he had a nose sharp enough to cut paper or something like that. And it just immediately puts a vision in your mind. He's a genius, or he was a genius writer. It's about Laidlaw, a police officer. As usual, the damaged police always are in novels, aren't they? That's what you want. That's what you expect. But as I say, an absolutely brilliant book. Definitely highly recommended. If you've not been to Scotland or you're not aware of Scotland, it's a really good Scottish portrayal, Scottish book. I know it's well received in Scotland. It doesn't stereotype, but it really gets to sort of the grassroots level of what Scotland was all about at the time. So like I say, The Papers of Tony Veitch. There you go. And what I would say is what I think you can learn from this as a writer, as you know, I always give a few writer's tips in these book reviews, is your books might outlast you. So make sure that you've got all your legacy in place, because obviously this man's no longer around and I've just bought his book, and I'm sure it will go on for generations to come because it is such a classic book. And make sure that you stick by your principles and what you want to write about, because this probably doesn't hit all of the tropes you would expect. It's, like I say, it's a really gritty, grimy drama set in Glasgow, but then it's got the Dickensian characterisations in it, in my view anyway. And I'm sure that a lot of academics will probably quote various methods of his writing, because it is unique as far as I can see. And like I say, it has borne the genre Scottish noir because it was groundbreaking. So if you like something and you're really passionate about it, you'll get critics, you'll get people who don't like your book, but you'll get people who do. And if you're passionate about something and you really believe in it and you really put your heart and soul into it, then other people will love it as well. So stick by your guns. That's really all I'm going to say. I'm not going to give you any practical advice about writing. I just think it's important to write what you want to write about, what you're passionate about. Okay, so definitely go and read it. And I've already read Laidlaw. This is the second one. I'm now going to get the third one. So, Papers of Tony Veitch, William McIlvanney. Thanks for joining me. Go read. Bye.